the Adams G. Gibbs Community Sports and Music Complex. The EWC Lady Tigers with a 32-24 lead over the Xavier Gold Nuggets. We'll try to get some of the halftime statistics here before we go back into the live action. For Xavier, in the first half, they were 7 of 28 from the field. That's 25%. 2 of 3 from the three-point line. The best thing they did was shoot free throws at 80%, 8 of 10. For Edward Waters, their field goal percentage, not much better, 13 of 35. They were 1 of 10 from the three-point arc, 5 of 7. Where I would say the biggest contributions came from, as I see, I'm going to pull up the live stats, and let's see if those are there, but some other individual or team stats for Xavier, 13 turnovers in the ball game. For EWC, only 8. The leading scorers for Xavier right now appears to be a couple of players with 5. Shaylin Moore has 5. Essence Wells has 5. For EWC, they are led by Laterra Ransom with 9 and Laquanza Glover with 9. Of course, what's always interesting to note, Miss Shaquanza Brown, 5 points, 6 points, 5 rebounds, 6 assists, halfway to a triple-double, Roy.
Yeah, and the other part of that, like I said, there are a lot of hustle points in there where she didn't necessarily get credit for steals, but she caused havoc on at least 5 different plays where she jumped in the way, moved the ball around, someone else was able to get a hold of that ball. As you noted, one of the things that has kept EWC with this lead that they have right now are the amount of turnovers, but they are scoring points off of the Xavier turnovers. And that's what Xavier now has to look at doing.
Right, points off of turnovers. EWC with 16 points off of turnovers compared to 9 for Xavier. What's also interesting, the bench scoring. Xavier, 15 of their 24 points have come from bench players. And of course, we've seen about 8 players come off the bench for them. So they've they've used 13 players. I think they brought 13. They've used everybody.
Yeah.
For EWC, only 4 points off the bench. Much smaller bench, though, with only 3 players coming off of it. Second chance points, another key stat here. EWC with 10 points and Xavier with 2. In that second quarter, Xavier did outscore the Lady Tigers 18-16. So 16 points scored by EWC in the first and second quarters.
But the difference is that first quarter, that 10-point lead that they had going into it.
16-6. That's a nice lead to start a game with.
Yeah, give yourself that kind of cushion. You know, Brian, you talked about the short bench that Coach Wilson has been using. That is one of the things that she talked about for a long time at the beginning of the season, that her teams would be one of the best conditioned teams, if not the best.
Mia Lake gets the scoring started with a 3-pointer. And nearly a steal.
That's going to be a foul.
Yep, she was able to time that just right. She gets fouled by Kyla Duncan.
Got grabbed by the neck is what happened there.
Why, you know, Kayla looked like, as she was slow to react to the ball, she realized she grabbed the ball and grabbed late as well. And so already a quick substitution for Xavier, as India Wells had checked into the ball game, or Essence Wells, excuse me, checked in. There's late into the lane. Nice soft touch. And she starts the quarter with 5 quick points. Puts the Lady Tigers up 37-24. And that 2-2-1, Shaylin Moore goes up the floor to Wells. Wells pulls it back out.
Again, the disruption by Miss Brown.
Maya Trench with the ball on the left side. Irons gives it over to Moore. Moore thought about the three. Goes right, pulls up, got Shaylin Moore with the nice sweet touch.
That was a two ball then. She stepped right inside of the arc on that one.
Moore has seven for Xavier. Late down low, that ball is off the hands of Shaylin Moore. She tried to interrupt that inside pass to Searles. And EWC will set their inbound play. Wow, there's a that play is inside. I watched Searles come off of the screen. She was wide open. Glover tries to go to the block, and let's see what we got, a hand in the back possibly, or what do we have? Yep. That foul.
11.
Yep. That's Irons, who was down on the block guarding Searles.
And India Searles is a very difficult matchup for both players on the offensive and the defensive end of the floor, Brian, because she has some very strong post moves that help her keep her quick feet moving, and, you know, those are the things that help her
late,
on the defensive side.
Late trying to go left through traffic. It ends up going off of her feet, and now they're back into that 2-2-1. The Gold Nuggets get across the half-court line. Trench, there's a three-point attempt by Wells. No good, but that attempt by Irons, and she gets fouled. I think they're going to call that on Ransom. Yes, they do. Latera Ransom, just her first. Three different Tigers, Lady Tigers, with 9 points. There's another free throw by Abrea Irons. Just a freshman. Xavier now shooting 10 of 12 from the three-point line. Doing a great job.
Free throw line, you mean?
I'm sorry, the free throw line. Thank you. Searles over to Ransom. She gives it over to Brown. Shaquanza Brown looks for some instructions, looks to set the offense up. Goes over to Searles. Thought about it. Goes back to Brown. Brown. Searles on a low block to Glover. Glover pump fake left. Nope. Rebound by Irons. Back comes Xavier. Ball in the hands of Shaylin Moore. She pulls for three. Bam.
Oh, my God.
On the logo. Gives her 10.
She was not even questioning whether or not she was going to take that shot.
Cuts the deficit to 6. 37-31. EWC lead. That's a tough pass as Glover tried to go from the far wing to Brown, who was standing on the weak side block.
Yeah, that's a difficult catch for Miss Brown.
Now they go back, they go into a 1-2-1-1. Cross court passing, breaks the press. Moore gives a little pump fake. Ransom got a hand up.
Definitely going to keep somebody in Miss Moore's face from this point forward.
Maya Trench dribbling all the way at the top of the key. Gives over to Wells. Down on the low block is Duncan. Duncan unable to get that, but Wells comes back up with Iron, Rebound by Ransom. Shaquanza Brown into the corner. Mia Late. 4-3. No good. Rebound. Two Tigers are there. I think he credits to Ransom. There's another three by Late. Unable to get him to fall today. Might have used up a little juice from on Saturday night. What do you think? There's almost a steal. A deflection. It is a steal. Ball in the hands of Glover. Nice
time.
Slide to the bucket. And we've got a timeout. Timeout on the floor. As of the 30-second timeout, I think we will stay here with the action during this 30-second timeout, 6:21 remaining. Lady Tigers, 39. Xavier, 31.
And, Brian, you know, as you mentioned it, one of the things that we've got going on right now is that these Lady Tigers are not really getting their shots going right now. Their outside shot. But, you know, again, we've got an eight-point lead. When your outside shot is not falling, you need to continue to go to the basket. They are having a lot of success inside of the paint, getting in and getting close to the rims, keeping their offense moving, not slowing down and setting up like they did in the first half. They were aggressively going to the basket. Shawanza Brown was making it a point to go hard to the basket, keeping that Gold Rush or Gold Nugget defense on its heels and not allowing them to get into a set defense.
Some of the other games taking place today on the women's side in the GCAC, we've got Suno traveling to Rust today. Also, Tougaloo traveling to Talladega. Talladega, of course, unbeaten in conference play at 12-0. And then we've got Dillard traveling to Philander Smith. So that's our women's schedule for today. Coming down to the final games of the conference season, as Roy, as you stated, the jockeying for position in the tournament is hot and heavy, especially in the middle rounds. There's a turnover as Shaylin Moore was trying to get that ball up ahead to Maya Trench. Trench didn't go deep enough down the court.
That
ends up
14?
Being a turnover.
That should be somewhere around number 14. And again, another unforced one. That was not anything that the defense did. They just made some bad movements.
There's Ransom, top of the key, no good. And we're going to call over the back.
Yeah. Miss Glover again getting low position. Yeah. Laquanza Glover again being aggressive. Like I said, down in that paint, man, she is a beast. And it is difficult for teams to defend her.
Ransom gives it over to Glover. 15 seconds on the shot clock. We've got 15 turnovers by Xavier in the contest thus far. Down on the low block is Searles. Nice quick move off the glass. No good. We're going to have a jump ball situation there between Irons and Glover. Possession arrow goes to Xavier. Anika Gasevich checks back into the ball game for Xavier. Outside shooter. She's knocked down a couple of threes thus far. There's Xavier. Oh. There's a block by Searles. It's got to be at least number three. She's on average, I would say, for today. Quickly up the court is Brown.
Yeah, she is continually, again, man, she is that eraser in the paint. She has such good instincts about when it is time to jump.
That ball was blocked. Back comes Xavier. Up ahead is Irons to the bucket. Gets that one to go.
And with that, Brian, this is the closest that Xavier has been in a while with a six-point deficit.
We are 39-33. 5 minutes remain in the quarter. Glover goes and is stolen away on the bad skip pass into the corner. Irons again to the bucket. Unable to get that one. Wow. Charge.
Woo. Bell White taking the charge for the team.
I felt that one. Good Lord. Kayla Duncan came full, and I'm talking full energy down the lane. And Bell White took that one. Wow, she definitely needs a timeout after that. We do too. You're watching Edward Waters College Basketball on the Black College Sports Network.
Is a premium health and wellness tea line focused on bringing delicious yet healthy tea blends to the community. Filled with an abundance of vitamins and antioxidants, we work to blend teas with exotic spices and fruits to produce scrumptious and wholesome beverages. So check us out at mymajesteas.com. That's mymajesteas.com. My Majesteas, an Urban Passport member.
Now, you can live in Texas and not have a good red meat blend. Texas Cowboy Dust is designed for steak and other red meats. It's out to be my most popular spice blend, made with onions, peppers, ground mushrooms, pink salt, and other spices. Texas Cowboy Dust also goes great with chicken, pork, vegetables, and has a restaurant-quality sheen to gravies and sauces.
Let's face it, shopping for insurance can be time-consuming. That's why when it comes to your auto, home, and life insurance needs, make things simple and trust the experts at Allstate. They will help you get the coverage that fits your needs while helping you bundle your life, home, and auto policies. Bundling saves you money, sure, but it also saves you time, so you can enjoy the things that matter most even more. Contact me, Tammy Haynes, your local agent, for a free personalized insurance quote. Allstate.
4:49 remaining in the third quarter of action. The Edward Waters Lady Tigers with a 39-33 lead over the Xavier Gold Nuggets. Shaquanza Brown just across the half court line, going right at the instruction of her coach, weaving through the screen. There's Bell White for three. No good. Sarles comes up with that rebound, unable to finish that. Glover comes down with it. She's unable to finish it. OC backup comes up with the rebound for Xavier. Splits through the double, finds your teammate, Wells. Wells pulls up, and she's going to catch a foul there. That's a smart heads-up play as she caught Sarles, who was trailing her. That's going to be Sarles' third personal foul. Unfortunately, I wish I could tell you the blocks. I know Sarah's only had one, but I mean, by our official, unofficial count, she's got at least two. Picked up that second one down there.
Yeah, Brandon, right now, the free throw line is keeping Xavier in this game.
Well, the 14 in the contest with that make by Wells, Essence Wells, the senior from Irving, Texas. 4-point ball game for EWC. Brown gets it to Late on the left wing. Goes cross court. Sarles comes up with it. Back to Late. She pulls up for three. No good, but she tips her own rebound out. Late seemed to be a little bit injured there. Xavier Ball with a chance to cut it to possibly one or two with a bucket here. Gold Nuggets with the ball. It's Gacevich. She goes into the corner to Wells for three. No good. Rebound. She did come up with her own rebound off the deflection. Goes back up with it. No good. Irons comes up with the rebound. Another offensive opportunity. Back up. She's unable to get that to fall. And finally, the Tigers get the ball to go out of bounds. They were unable to come up with it. Gave the Nuggets three opportunities there. Back in the hands of the Lady Tigers.
And, Brian, right now the Lady Tigers need to get something completed of their offense. The last two possessions they've had turnovers, didn't get the ball into the plays that they wanted, and now we've got to try to get something that's going to be –
Late
unable, to get some points.
Late unable to get that shot. Then Ransom unable to make hers. The lid just does not seem to be very friendly for the home team today. This is where your defense has to come in. They just have to, eventually they'll start to fall. You just got to stay in this ball game. And again, that big first quarter playing huge factor right now in this contest. There's Gacevich for three. Bounces over the backboard.
Yeah, Brian, right now, like I said, I think what they need to do is they need to get back to their transition offense. And the transition offense is what had them ahead by 10 in the first quarter.
There's Glover going back to Glover.
And there you go.
That was Brown to Glover, excuse me.
Yeah.
Gets that bucket to fall.
Again, Brown gets the offense going, doesn't give the defense an opportunity to get itself set. And you get clean looks close to the basket.
Glover has 13 points, leading all scorers in this contest. 41-35. Xavier down low. There's backup. She's trying to post up. Turns left. Soft touch. Bounces. Nope, she does tip and get her own rebound. Searles. It does go out of bounds on OC backup.
Again, let's get the ball moving. Get into your offense quickly. Do not allow this Lady Gold Nugget defense to get set, especially with backup in the paint. There
nice
you go.
Pass there from Brown down low to India Searles.
Again,
43-35 lead. Back come the Gold Nuggets. There's Wells going to the bucket. And she got hit by a couple of Lady Tigers. Let's see who they give it to.
They're
going to
call that one on Ransom.
Call that on Latera Ransom, her second, team third. 1:49 to play. I don't know if it's a good strategy to continue to send Xavier to the free throw line.
Well, they, like I said, they have been very efficient from the line.
Alexis Burke appears to have checked in for OC backup as Wells knocks down the first one. 13 of 15 is what Xavier is shooting at the free throw line in this contest. Officials come together here. I'm not sure. Here we go. Second attempt by Wells. That one is good. 43-37. Lady Tigers ball. Shaquanza Brown. They're trying to double her. Unable to. Finds it. There's another double. And they find the ball finds Brown. There's a quick handoff late. A little crossover move through the lane. No good. Wells with the rebound. Gives it over to Trench. Maya Trench going opposite. Avoiding the double that was coming.
I think
on the low block is Burke. Nice pull-up jump shot by Alexis Burke. 43-39.
Back to a four-point lead.
There's another double team there on Brown. She's got to find her teammates. She finds Searles. Brown trying to split the double. Nope, she's being guarded there by Irons. Goes inside to Ransom. Ransom got
That's
whacked.
That's going to be foul. There you go.
There's a hard foul.
As get in there.
Send Searles to the free throw line. She gets whacked across the forearm by Alexis Burke.
Actually, it's Latera Ransom that'll be going to the line. But that's what, again, that's what you got to do. You got to keep movement. You cannot allow this Gold Nugget team to get set in their defense.
First free throw attempt by Ransom. Front of the rim, no good. That is only the eighth free throw attempt by the Lady Tigers in this contest. There's number nine. She got the second one to fall. Lexia Bell-White checks in, and India Searles comes out. 55.1 seconds left.
Let's see if Lexia Bell-White can get her, can find her shot today.
And they're 1-2, 1-1, press there. And there's a stolen away by Lee. They've got numbers. She goes fake. Oh, she tried to go over to Glover on the right side. Ball in the hands of Brown. She's wide open. That's a three. No good. Maya Trench comes to a dead stop to prevent anyone from coming up with that ball. And back into a 2-2-1 go to Lady Tigers. Trench comes up the middle of the floor over to Irons. Irons down low to Burke. The execution is sharp by Xavier against the 2-2-1. Now they come to double Brown. And it's going to be stolen away. Collision. Brown comes up with it. Picks up a screen. Late. For three, settles herself, no good. Rebound, all the way up ahead is Wells. It's 2-on-1, late, tried to stick in there, but they call it with a blocking foul.
Oh.
Mia Late did the best she could down there by herself.
Yeah, she looked like she went straight up on that one to me, Brian. But just held her position, rather not even go straight up, she held her position got a hold of the ball, but again, you're getting, like you said, you can't keep putting these Lady Gold Nuggets on the free throw line.
44-41. There's 1.9 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Xavier has outscored EWC. In this third quarter, free throw attempt is good by Essence Wells. There's another one. Man, I tell you. 44-43, 1 point ball game, 1.9 seconds remaining. Let's see what we have going on here. Trying to figure out what the situation is.
They're not letting a substitution
They're not letting a substitution
like.
Come in, so Mia Late tried to come in, but they're not going to let her in, which means India Saros has to stay in. There's Brown. 1.9 seconds, not much you can do. I think initially what they thought about doing was the head Glover possibly throwing deep, but Xavier did a good job of recognizing it. Well, we've got ourselves a ball game going into the fourth quarter. Edward Waters, Lady Tigers, with a one-point lead. We'll be back for the fourth quarter after these words. You're watching Edward Waters College Basketball on the Black College Sports Network.
You in good hands?
Q-Time is our classic Atlanta soul food restaurant located in the historic West End. Q-Time Soul Food is a family business started by Fred and Christine Crenshaw. Come on in, relax, and sink your chops into our tantalizing, mouth-watering, distinctive soul food with a twist, the Q-Time way. 1120 Ralph David Abernathy Boulevard, or call your order in at 404-758-2881. Do you miss your mama's cooking? Then come on down to Q-Time, an Urban Passport member.
A gentleman wanted to do the Black College Sports Network in partnership with the HBCUs.
Around the world. Book today at Doubletree.com. Doubletree by Hilton, where the little things mean everything.
Here we go for the start of the fourth quarter here. EWC Lady Tigers with a 44-43 lead over the Xavier Gold Nuggets. As the Tigers start with the ball. Gold Nuggets in a 2-3 zone. EWC looking to try to get the ball inside. They go cross court.
That's going to be a foul.
Glover. Yeah. And, yep, that foul on number 5, Alexis Burke.
Brian, and again, like I said, these, if you're going to do that, you've got to keep the motion if you're going to stay.
There's Ransom, Latera Ransom, gives it over to Shaquanza Brown. Baseline, gives it over to India Saros. Can't go anywhere. Put up a shot, no good. Rebound by Maya Trench. Xavier with an opportunity to take a lead, something that they have not had since early in the first quarter. Ball is stolen away. All the way up the floor, pass to Glover. Knifing through the lane is Saros. Has it knocked out of her hands
ball rolled
by
off
Maya
her body.
Trench, and then it rolls off her leg and out of bounds. Try to set some score, some of these statistics. The biggest thing I'm noticing, Xavier outscored EWC 19-12 in that third quarter, and the trend from the first quarter to the third has been going different directions. For Xavier, They started with six, 18 in the second, 19 in the third. Driving to the lane, just drops that one off. Nearly stolen away from Xavier by Brown. Virgil puts up a shot, and there's that lead. Xavier takes the lead, 45-44. I don't think they've had a lead since very early in the first quarter.
Since the first two free throws, Brian, this is the first lead that they have had this game.
Good call. Late driving to the bucket, unable to get that one to fall. Virgil comes up with it. Gives it over to Shaylen Moore. Moore, two on one, decides to hesitate, but it's blocked by Ransom. And then she gives it away to Shaylen Moore, who goes inside. And there's a foul from behind. Alexis Burke will go to the free throw line as Shaquanza Brown fouled her. So it was a great defensive play by Ransom, but Mia Late comes out of the ball game as Lexia Bell White comes in. Free throw shooting. First three quarters. 16 of 18 is what Xavier has shot in this contest. That's 88.89%. And, I mean, if that is the stat of the day right there. EWC has only attempted 9 free throws. That was the 17th made by Xavier. And there's number 18. So now they have a 3-point lead, the Gold Nuggets do, 47-44.
And the Lady Tigers have got to get back to what they were doing well in the first half.
Bill White tried to skip that off the glass, but was unsuccessful there. Rebound by Xavier, pushing up ahead. There's Burke, all the way, and she got called for a travel.
She's looking like she's not sure what she did there.
Yeah, just a few extra steps there. It's back into the ball game. Mia Late comes in for Lexia Bell White.
Yeah, Lexia Bell White has not been able to find her long range stroke from today, Brian.
Xavier staying in that 2-3. You know, if given how poorly, and oh, check that. They went to man to man now. There's Brown with the ball off the screen. There's Ransom for three. Back of the rim, no good. Rebound by Irons. Gives it over to Virgil, being guarded tightly. Gives it over to Trench. Trench being guarded by Mia Late. Coach calling for some motion here.
Oh, good steal by Mia Late.
Just a little too much on the dribble. Watch the spin move. She goes from left to right. Throws it up, unable to get that to fall. Latera Ransom is able to help her out there. Brown into the lane. She kind of collected. She lost it and then collected herself. Got that bucket to fall. 47-46. Xavier lead. Brown nearly stolen away. A lot of reaching going on by the Lady Tigers. And if she does, come from
behind. Oh, there is that hustle, though. You gotta love that hustle.
Gotta always know where she's at. Even if you go by her, you better believe she's coming right behind you. Checking in right now for Xavier, 35, Kyla Duncan. And Abrea Irons checks out. It'll be interesting to see if Xavier shortens their rotation here in this fourth quarter. First half, they were very fluid with their substitutions.
Another steal.
Duncan lost control of that ball. Here comes Glover on the right side. Gives it over to Ransom. Pull-up jump shot, no good. No legs on that shot as it hit the front of the rim. Wells with the ball. Lady Tigers in a full-court press. If they break this, there's nobody back deep to help. Wow, nice shot by Deja Virgil. Back comes EWC, quickly up ahead, ball in the hands of India Searles. Mia Late, 49-46 lead for Xavier. 6:20 remaining, Late down low. Nice soft touch off the glass, India Searles off the great pass by Mia Late. We've got a timeout on the floor. We'll be back right after these words. You're watching Edward Waters College Basketball on the Black College Sports Network.
It's like a loot machine. Going around town, trying to get down.
back to live action here on the campus of Edward Waters College. 6:16 remaining in the fourth quarter and contest. Xavier with a 49-48 lead. Talked about the three-point shooting by both teams has been horrible. EWC is 2 of 20 from behind the arc. Xavier is 3 of 16. So if this game is going to be won, it's going to be in the paint. Or off the free throw line, I should say. From the logo, Moore unable to get that one. Strong rebound by Brown. Quickly on the break. Numbers. Goes over to Ransom. Count it. And the Lady Tigers have regained the lead. 50-49.
And there it is, Brian.
Transition break. Right in front of us. Xavier advances. Ball in the hands of Shaylen Moore. Gives it over to Deja Virgil.
Transition offense is what got the Lady Tigers a 10-point lead in the first half. They've got to get back to getting up and down the court. That is the strength of their offense.
Inside, there's Duncan. Pump fake and off the glass and back in front are the Gold Nuggets. 51-50, coming up on 5 minutes remaining. I have a feeling this is how this quarter and these last 5 minutes are going to go back and forth. There's Brown using the screen, gives it over to Glover. Glover over to Late. Gives it back to Glover. Off the glass, she is fouled.
There you go.
Going up, she is fouled by Kyla Duncan. That is her fourth. Her fourth personal foul. Team second. Laquanza Glover at the line. She's 3 of 3 thus far in the contest.
And Brian, again, going to the basket, that's what's going to either happen. You're either going to get a good shot or you're going to get fouled. Especially Laquanza Glover. She is so strong in the paint for these Lady Tigers, and they've got to continue to use that on that motion offense.
Second attempt by Glover is good. She's 5 for 5 as a team high, as a game high, 15 points. 4:50 remaining and puts the Lady Tigers back on top, 52-51. There's Virgil going right, gives it over to Shaylen. She thought about it, gives it back to Virgil. Moore to Duncan, Duncan over to Wells. Wells right into the lane. Where's that foul at? They say that foul was shooting attempt or on the floor, wow. They're gonna say another shooting attempt foul. Foul on Mia Late.
They continue to get to the line.
Her second, yeah. Essence Wells, 8 of 8 at the free throw line in this game. This might be one of the best free throw shooting performances I've seen a team display. And I can't even, I want to say ever, possibly. And you know, I've been watching a lot of college basketball on different levels. Don't know if I've seen anything like this. 53-52 lead for the Gold Nuggets.
You know, and you know, the interesting piece, Brian, though, is like you
inside
said.
Inside the Glover, off the glass, it's good.
I keep telling you, they cannot deal with Laquanza Glover in the paint, on the low block, anywhere near that area.
Why?
She can be dominant in this game.
I would say it looks like the strategy for EWC is get the ball inside for the Gold Nuggets. There's a three-point attempt. No good. Coming up with that rebound is Mia Late. I was going to say it appears like the Gold Nuggets strategy is to drive the ball. Wow, Brown just blows by. 1, 2, 3 defenders.
Oh,
all the way to the
there
front.
You go.
Absolutely ridiculous. Just the separating speed from the double team blowing past the next defender. Wow. Shaquanza Brown puts the Lady Tigers up 3, 56-53, a chance for the old school three-point play. And a four-point lead. That's a big play. 3:42 left in the quarter.
In the game. And that's what you need. You need your leader to step up and make a play when you've got to get some energy. Miss Brown is the player that can get it for you.
Brown has 11 points and 10 assists. A couple of rebounds away from a triple-double. Three-point attempt, no good on that air ball. Rebound by Ransom. Here comes Brown again. And she'll make the smart decision. They'll run the offense here. There's a run, a little weave action here. Glover to Late. Late gives it over to Brown. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Here comes Late. Will she shoot the three? She does. Ah, unable to get that. Tipped by Glover. Brown gets the ball all the way back out. Give credit to Glover. 15 seconds on the shot clock. Running back to that weave again. Glover to Late. Late will pick up a cross screen. Gives it over to Brown. 5 seconds on the clock. Got to make something. Brown pulls up. No good. But there's Ransom, and she's fouled.
That's a foul. There
that's Searles, excuse me.
Searles, yep.
That was Searles with the timely rebound and the quick shot attempt, and she will go to the free throw line.
Yeah.
Foul on number 15, Essence Wells. That is her third. India Searles at the free throw line. This is her first free throw attempt of the game. Unable to get that one to fall. And 57-53, EWC lead, 2:38 to play. Second attempt, good. 5-point lead. Shaylin Moore.
They are going to keep her covered.
Left side, goes to the rim, and she draws that foul there by on India Searles.
Yeah, I think that time India should not have swiped at the ball. She had the position, actually. That would have been a very difficult shot for that young lady to make.
Shaylin Moore, 10 points on the contest. She's 2 of 2 right now. Knocks that down, of course. Xavier's 21 of 23 at the free throw line as a team. Cannot to continue. Another one's good. Can't emphasize how impressive this is, folks.
But Brian, 24, and you said that I believe EWC has actually only been to the line.
They've only been to
times.
The line, well, 13, 12 times, excuse me. There's a steal by Moore. Moore doesn't see her teammate up ahead, going to the bucket, tosses it up, and it's in. Cuts the deficit to 1, 58 to 52. We got a timeout on the floor by Coach Wilson with 2:08 left. We will take a timeout. You're watching Edward Waters College Basketball on the Black College Sports Network.
It didn't. What happened was a gentleman wanted to do the Black College Sports Network. In partnership with the HBCU or these black colleges.
Yes, absolutely.
And it would have educated the Black College Sports Network. This is what he wanted to do. That would have educated a lot of black kids.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. That was the real reason why I got into it, was when I saw what happened with the Black College Sports Network, which I.
Majesty is a premium health and wellness tea line focused on bringing delicious yet healthy tea blends to the community. Filled with an abundance of vitamins and antioxidants, we work to blend teas with exotic spices and fruits to produce scrumptious and wholesome beverages. So check us out at mymajesties.com. That's MYMAJESTEAS.com. My Majesties, an Urban Passport member.
.208 left to play in this contest. Both teams, Edward Waters and Xavier, fighting for that sixth win. A game that could very well decide who gets the four seed heading into the GCAC tournament.
And the reason that four seed is so important, Brian, is that it is the team that gets to host the home game in that first round.
Under two to play. Glover goes up with it, and awkward. Not even, she didn't even face the bucket. She just kind of tossed it over her shoulder. gives the Lady Tigers a three-point lead, 60-57. Oh, into the sideline. Unbelievable save there by Wells. Oh,
that's an elbow.
Two spectacular plays by the Gold Nuggets, one by Essence Wells, and then on the shot by Deja Virgil, 60-59, Lady Tigers lead. Mia Lake goes baseline. Little Euro step, count that bucket. 62-59. Coach Wilson tells her team to get back and pick up. Don't want to have Xavier beat you in transition, so they're going to get back and play defense. Shaylin Moore for three. No good off the back of the rim. Rebound by Duncan. Goes up with it. Rolls around and in. Kyla Duncan gets that to fall. One-point ball game again. Under a minute to play. 50 seconds, in fact.
Got to get a good shot here, Brian. We got to get a good shot.
Shaquanza Brown over to India Searles. Back to Brown. Xavier playing man-to-man. Hands it over to Ransom. And let's see. We've got... We've got a three-second called on Glover, Laquanza Glover.
That is a bad call. She was constantly moving. She was not set in the paint at any point.
Okay. Well, let's see. We've got a full timeout, so we'll take a break. 62-61, our score. You're watching Edward Warner's College Basketball on the Black College Sports Network.
Now, you can live in Texas and not have a good red meat blend. Texas Cowboy Dust is designed for steak and other red meats. It's out to be my most popular spice blend, made with onions, peppers, ground mushrooms, pink salt, and other spices. Texas Cowboy Dust also goes great with chicken, pork, vegetables, and adds a restaurant-quality sheen to gravies and sauces.
Let's face it. Shopping for insurance can be time-consuming. That's why when it comes to your auto, home, and life insurance needs, make things simple and trust the experts at Allstate. They will help you get the coverage that fits your needs while helping you bundle your life, home, and auto policies. Bundling saves you money, sure, but it also saves you time, so you can enjoy the things that matter most even more. Contact me, Tammy Haynes, your local agent, for a free personalized insurance quote. Allstate, are you in good hands?
Welcome back to the Adam Jenkins Center here. We are at 38.6 seconds left in this final quarter. The Lady Tigers hold on to a one-point lead.
Inbound on the sideline, ball in the hands of number 14, Deja Virgil. Guarded by Shaquanza Brown. Going left, there's a handoff to Essence Wells. Shaylin Moore around the top of the key, dribbling right. Over to Duncan. Duncan goes left, avoids the contact. Misses the basket, and she is fouled. Mia Late is fouled. Had to foul her there before she pushed that ball up the floor. I don't think they're in the bonus, are they? Yes, they are.
They're called that. She gets the shoot. All right.
Well, Duncan, I think she lost her footing going to the bucket because she had an opportunity there to make that basket. Mia Late at the free throw line. She has 12 in the contest. ...63-61 lead for the Lady Tigers. 19.3 left to play. Second attempt is good. Three-point ball game now. We got a 30 seconds.
All right. Brian, you're a coach. If you are Coach Browder, what are you drawing up right now?
Well, I think there's still 19.3 left. I think there's still time to play for another two-point basket, which, you know, I'd be surprised, given the fact that neither team has shot well. I mean, Xavier's 3 of 19 right now from the three-point line. Now, I did notice that they did put Anika Gasevic in the ball game. I believe she might be a three-point shooter, although the only one probably I want shooting a three at this point is Shaylin Moore. But I still think there's time to go get a two.
With that said, what are you doing if you're Coach Wilson? What are you telling your girls?
Well, you're probably still playing man-to-man. You're switching every screen. I just think they have the lead, a three-point lead. They need to play every possession.
Hey!
There's Shaylin Moore on the right. Or check that. There's Shaylin Moore with the ball in her hands. Three-point attempt. No good. Coming up with that ball. Late comes up with it. And she's fouled. So that was Deja Virgil with that three-point attempt, which was no good. 5.3 seconds left.
And right now, one of your captains, your senior Mia Late, can put this game on ice.
13 points in the contest. She's 2 of 2 at the free throw line with a chance to basically, with two makes, put it on ice. First one, no good.
Really, all she needs is one of these, Brian, because it's a two-point. That would make it still going to be a two-possession ball game.
Well, there's still time. If they've got timeouts, no timeouts left, so Xavier has to advance the ball off the dribble. They can't call the timeout off the miss. There's the make.
That's
65-61. Moore comes up the floor, 3-2, half-court heave. No good. And the Heaven Waters College Lady Tigers have picked up their sixth conference win with a 65-61 victory over the Xavier Gold Nuggets. A big conference win for the Lady Tigers. We'll take a break, step away, and come back with halftime with post-game statistics and get ready for our men's contest. We're watching Heaven Waters College basketball on the Black College Sports Network.
Q Time is our classic Atlanta soul food restaurant located in the